Much-loved pooches have been pampered at a pop-up cafe to celebrate International Guide Dog Day. And while they were lapping up all of that extra attention, the people they help say they're still facing a lot of obstacles. Neary Tai has the story.
At just 8 weeks old, Iris and Ica are still finding their feet. But the Golden Labradors certainly know how to lap up the attention. While it's puppy love for now, these pooches will go on to be lifelong companions, helping those living with low vision and blindness.
I absolutely couldn't imagine life without her.
Lucy Carpenter says Dottie helped her navigate the final years of uni.
She has just been with me every step of the way.
Being third generation blind, Mel Stevens taught her Penelope commands in French so her mother's guide dog wouldn't get confused.
Oui, madame.
The 30-year-old from Kyneton says Penn has given her the confidence to do the things she loves, like riding horses and playing footy.
Person catches the ball, hands the ball to me, grabs my shoulders, turns me around and say, kick that way. And I've kicked a goal from 25 out.
But there are still obstacles for those living with a disability. 70% of guide dog handlers have had trouble accessing public spaces, and nearly half of people living with blindness are turned away from taxis and ride shares.
He ended up cancelling the ride and driving off and leaving me there by myself late at night at a pretty deserted train station.
Members of the public might not realise, but you're not actually supposed to touch a guide dog when they're working out in the community. So I'm sneaking in all the cuddles I can now with this future guide dog.
Over in Kensington, volunteers are hoping to raise $150,000 for Vision Australia.
This is the second time I've met him and I already love him so much.
Neary Tai, Nine News.